Footprints of a Saint is a closer look at the life and mission of Blessed Kuriakose alias Chavara. The first Indian to be beatified, Blessed Chavara was born on the 10th of February 1805 to devout Catholic parents at Kainagari in Kerala. He was ordained priest in 1829. In 1831, together with Fathers Thomas Palakil and Thomas Porukara, he founded the first indigenous religious congregation for men, now known as the Carmelites of Mary Immaculate, the CMI. With Father Leopold, he also founded the first indigenous congregation for women, known as the CMC, in 1866. Numerous were his pioneering works. As the Vicar General of the Siro Malabar Church, he saw to it that a school was established attached to every church all over Kerala. He also set up the first ever printing press in Travancore and the first Catholic Sanskrit school. He also started the first home for the destitute and entrusted it to the care of lay people. He single-handedly rousted the Rococism and restored unity in the turbulent Malabar Church. Amidst all these activities, he led a profound contemplative life. He profusely translated into poetry some of his intense spiritual experiences. The epic poem, The Compunction of the Soul, The Martyrdom of Anastasia, The Testament of a Loving Father, Meditation Discourses, and Requiem Hymns are some. He, together with his associates, spearheaded a spiritual renaissance which ushered in a second spring in Kerala Church.
It is not I, but God did all this. How did you come till here? Who called you from home? How did you ascend to the altar of God? How was the community formed? Who gave you the name prior? Are you worthy of anything of these? Never, certainly never. That means in everything God's will happen, and it will be made to happen.
Come. ആക്കിയ സ്നേഹത്താൽ അമ്മഞ്ഞപ്പാലു തന്നു വളർത്തുമ്പോൾ അന്നവൾക്കു നീ നൽകിയ സ്നേഹത്താൽ അമ്മഞ്ഞപ്പാലു തന്നു വളർത്തുമ്പോൾ ആയതിനോടു ചേർത്തു ജപങ്ങളും അപ്പോൾ തന്നെ ഗ്രഹിപ്പിച്ചു തന്നവൾ. അന്നവളുടെ കാൽക്കലിരുന്നു ഞാൻ മന്ദമായറിഞ്ഞു ദൈവത്തെയും മന്ദമായതു കേട്ടിരുന്നു കൊണ്ടാം സുന്ദരിയുടെ പാതയുറങ്ങി ഞാൻ. ഒരു കാലവും യാതൊരു കാരണത്താൽ കരുവീലും കരത്താലും തൊട്ടില്ല. അങ്ങനെ വളർത്തേടുന്ന കാലത്തിൽ ദൈവത്തിനു ഇഷ്ടഞ്ഞ
മമ്മി അ പ്രീസ്റ്റ്.
ഓ
Father, praise be to Jesus.
Praise forever. Whose house is this?
This is our house, Chavara house.
I am Father Thomas Palakal. I teach in Pallipuram Seminary.
Father, please come to our house.
I will come on my return.
Yes, Father.
My aunt lives somewhere here. I am looking for her house, the Kalasari family.
It's on the 13th. My son Kuriakos will take you there.
Kuriakos, do you know the house?
Yes, Father. We used to play there.
Oh, that's fine. Come, Kuriakos. My son, thanks for showing me the way. Now let me show you a way.
To where, Father?
The way to God. Don't you like to be a priest?
Oh, how much I like to be a priest.
I will speak to your parents.
Oh, mother will say I'm too young. She thinks I'm still a baby.
She's right. You are young. For some time, you stay with your parish priest so you can see your parents. Then I shall take you to Pallipuram Seminary. This is the prayer our father in Syriac.
Father, some visitors for you.
Kuriakos?
Yes, father.
You help your friends with the lesson.
Sure, father.
Let me meet the visitors.
Abunda Bashmaya. It means our Father in heaven. Although we say our Father in heaven, God is very close to us, closer than we can think. We call our God dearly, more dearly than we call our fathers, like dear Papa.
Kuriakos, Father is calling you. Some visitors have come from your home.
From my home?
Thank you.
my father and brother did not come.
Your uncles have brought some sad news.
What? What happened?
Kuriakos, we never know the divine will of God. Some epidemic happened in your village. Smallpox. And the government passed an order that no one should go out of the village, nor should anyone enter the village. It was to check the spread of the disease to other places. So they could not come early and give you the news.
What news? Isn't everybody well at home?
That's what they have come to say. That epidemic took away your parents and your brother.
My father, my mother, and my brother? No.
It's really very, very sad, my son. We never know the will of God. Let's pray for their souls. For a few days, you may go with your uncles.
Kuriakos, what are you doing?
I'm packing my things. Today I'm going back to the seminary.
You are not going anywhere. You are the only one in the house. And if you go, who will take care of all these properties and house?
I have spoken to my sister and brother-in-law and given the house and property in their name.
What did they say?
Initially they didn't agree, but when they heard my decision to become a priest, they agreed.
They may agree, but we won't agree. You are not going anywhere.
But uncle, I have decided to go.
You are not going anywhere.
Uncle, please open the door. Uncle, please. Uncle, please open the door. Let me go. Uncle, please.
We have to do something. The boy hasn't eaten anything for the last 2 days.
After a few days, everything will be all right.
Son, what they say is true. You are the only one left in the family. And if you become a priest, this family will come to an end. So, get married and settle here.
No, I have settled everything with my sister. Uncle, please open the door. Let me go.
I have told everything to our father Givagis.
Oh, that's true. When he comes, he will make him understand everything. Father D.
Avracha, what you said is true. He's the only one to carry on the family line. I spoke to Kuriakos, but his decision is firm. Moreover, there is no priest in our Chavara family. It's a great blessing from God to have a saintly priest in the family. Let him join the seminary. God will look after everything here.
Thank you, Father. Thank you so much.
Father Kuriakos, today I feel very happy after receiving the permission for our long-cherished dream for the monastic life. I feel more energetic and enthusiastic.
This surely is a blessing from God. My special prayer on my first Mass was to have a hermitage established. A lot of good works were not done because there's not a group of dedicated people.
The bishop was right. Instead of all of us going to hermitage, seeking our own salvation, in the monastic life, it is better that we can take care of the people too. Now we have to look for a suitable place for the monastery. Father Porukra will arrive soon, and we will see some places. The ideal place will be a small hilltop away from the hassle bustle of the people.
The solitude of a hilltop will be very ideal for our spiritual pursuit, but it should be accessible to the people by land and water.
Yes, something like that will be right. See, Father Porukara has come.
Kanyantara Jacob also is with him.
This young man is with a lot of fire and zeal within him.
Were you waiting for us a long time?
No, let's go now. Now more than 15 places we saw, and how many miles we traveled.
Pullarikund was a beautiful hill, but the objection of the people also is right in that way. They think it is the sanctuary of goddess.
We should not build our monastery hurting the sentiments of the people of any other religion.
You may remember the place I have shown you on the way to Pullarikund.
Maybe that is the place God has shown for us. We shall go there.
This place is really beautiful.
God, through different ways, was leading us here.
We can reach here by land and water.
We shall build our monastery here. We shall call this Vishrama, the house on hilltop. Jacob, you get the permission for this land. Father Kuriakos, you have a letter from the bishop.
Must be an important one.
These days the bishop seems to have some misunderstanding about the monastery works. That's why he was very harsh with us when we met him last.
Father, this is an appointment letter. I'm appointed the vicar of Pallipuram.
Father Porukara is also away.
Now, who will take care of the work of the monastery? Shall I meet Bishop and request him?
That also could be thought of.
Yes, come in.
Your Grace, I came to make a humble supplication. I got the appointment order, but if I go to a faraway parish, there will be no one left to look after the monastery works.
Have we not learnt to obey the tastes of your prelate?
It's not that way, Your Grace. Father Balakil has to be in the seminary, and moreover, he has become sick and very old. Father Purukara is also away. There will be no one left at Mananam.
Is it the way you speak to your superiors? Obey the order.
I'm sorry. Please forgive my impertinence.
Father, be at peace. Archbishop has got something on his mind. He His grace has given transfer order to Father Parukara too. I know it's disheartening. Have faith. Very soon, everything will be all right.
What may come, we will obey.
Now both of you are back here. I think the Archbishop was pleased by your obedience.
Very soon we have to complete the works and start monastic life over here.
Hey there! I saw Father Chavara going this way.
This way? There stays that big cobra which has killed many
people.
Let's
go and see. Take something to kill the snake.
Take rest. Let me pray for a while. Do not hurt anyone. Go on your way. Today is the happiest day of my life. We got the recognition and permission for our congregation.
How many years we were waiting for this day? We had applied to both of the former vicar apostolates. Archbishop Francis Xavier and Archbishop Ludvikos did not consider our application.
Archbishop Bernardinus is very kind to accept our application. He's like a loving father to us. Now, the souls of our elders, Father Palakal and Porukara, will be rejoicing in heaven.
After their demise, all the burden of the monastery came upon you.
Still, we have a heavy burden on us. Because of a lack of committed people, a lot of good works remain undone. The idea of founding the religious congregation came to us because of that. And our Kerala church, having received the faith from Apostle Thomas in the first century itself, remained barren. We have not produced any saint. See, Father Bhopal, there is no chance for our devout women to lead a dedicated life. We should start a religious congregation for them. They alone can educate girls and empower the women. Our faithful need prayer books and spiritual books to read. There should be pious associations for them. And if not we, who will take care of the poor and the destitute?
Now, a good number of people are attracted to religious life. and we will have more monasteries.
That's true. After the retreat, on 8th of December, we will make our first profession. As the expansion of our congregation happens, we have to remember one thing. The strength of any monastery is not the thickness of the walls, but mutual love of the members staying inside.
I, Kuriakos Elias of the Holy Family, though unworthy, relying on divine mercy, and resolved to respond to God's special call in total commitment to serve God and His people in His congregation, profess to the Most Holy Trinity my vows of chastity, poverty, and obedience for my life.
Dear Fathers, now by the order of the Archbishop, I declare Father Kuriakos Elias of the Holy Family the prayer of the Society of the Servants of Mary Immaculate.
Amen.
Father Prior, today there are lots of people in the construction work. We have no money at all to pay the wages.
I too am thinking of that. People have generously contributed to all our works. We are doing the work of God, and God will provide us.
Father, I'd like to contribute some money for the monastery.
You have given a big amount.
If needed more, please send someone to me.
Thank you, sir. May God bless you. This Rokas coming as bishop has created a lot of problems, and it's spreading like wildfire.
Now the majority of the churches have gone after him. Out of 154 parishes, 86 have gone fully, and 30 are partially with them. Only 38 parishes remain with the church.
I have written already 5 letters to Rome to know the truth about the legitimacy of Bishop Rokas. I have also written to the Holy Father that the root of all these problems is that our church does not have a bishop of our own right and culture.
See, only now Archbishop Bernardinus appointed you as the vicar general of the churches of our right. Till this time, these foreign bishops did not want to share their authority with us. When they saw that the situation is going out of their control, they thought about you.
We should not look at these things that way. You know very well that I did not want to be a bishop nor to hold post of authority. But when the mother church is in danger, as true children of the church, we have to work hard. To save the church from all schisms, I'm ready even to give up my life.
Father Prior, we have seen Bishop Rokas. What a fortune that we have got a bishop of our own right. If you just come and kiss his ring, it will be a great encouragement for all of us.
I'm ready not only to kiss his hands, but even his feet. But I would not kiss his ring, because he has come without proper authority. Remember the Lord's saying, one who comes to the back door is not a true shepherd, but a thief.
Splendor, O Son of God, I long to see. the crowd and seizingly offered praise and worship. I long to see the loving boy the angels adore.
What's your name?
Appu.
Appu? Do you want to study?
Mm.
I'll come to your home and talk to your mother. Come. Says he wants to study.
Yes, he's interested very much.
Then send him to our school.
Father, people won't allow us. We are of low caste. Our children should not sit with other children.
In our school, you can send him. There, all of them sit together.
Now, he tends the cattle of the landlord. So, at noon, he gets meal there. Father, if he goes to school, who will give him food to eat?
In our school, we will arrange midday meals. Next Monday, send him to our school. We will give him clothes too.
Father?
Father Prior, still busy with work?
Yes, I was writing a circular to all the churches.
Anything special?
See, if every church starts a school, a lot of children will be able to study.
A very good idea. Very soon, Kerala would be educated. Do you think that churches will do it?
I will have to give strict instructions. And if any church is not obeying, the permission for the sacraments will be withdrawn. Moreover, in our schools, there should not be any kind of caste discrimination.
Will the people agree to that?
All are the children of the same father. We will have to eradicate caste discrimination from the society.
If we do not guide the people, who will do that?
I'm adding one more idea to that. Every school should provide midday meal for the poor children in order to make it a great success.
Will it not be burdensome? How will they manage it?
Generous people will help us. You know, all the good works will succeed with the cooperation of the people.
Putting rice in this?
It is Father Prior's suggestion that we give a small portion of rice for poor children every time when we cook.
But this is very little.
True, this is very little. But if we give every time we cook, it will be a good portion. And if every house gives like this, it will be so much enough for many children. Every Saturday, we have to take you to Father Chavara.
Mummy, next Saturday, I will take you to Father Chavara.
Sure.
My mother is very sick. Father, please come to give her last sacrament.
Let me take the holy oil.
Did you tell Father that she has caught smallpox?
No.
You know very well that he may not come knowing that. Father Prior, do you know that she is returned with smallpox?
So what?
No one visits such patients. Even doctors and relatives refuse to go.
I'm a priest, and it's my duty to go. The rest I leave to God. Come, let's rush.
What's the matter? Something serious?
I was telling him, Father Prior is going out of his senses.
What do you mean?
Clearly speaking, Father Prior is really, really mad. Smallpox killed his father, mother, and his only brother. Now he is going to a smallpox patient. He says God will take care of him.
That's true. Father Prior is a man of prayer. He thinks God's thoughts. Even Bishop Athanasius believes Father Prior is a saint. And he says, who will go to heaven from this land except Father Chavara? I will try to reach there by clinging to his belt.
Father Prior's holiness, we all approve. But his madness, that's what we are worried about. We heard that he is planning to make a printing press. Here no one has heard about it. He himself hasn't seen one. Is it not madness?
How many things Father Prior did which we have not even heard of? This monastery, the religious congregation, 40 hours adoration, when he spoke about home for destitute, I myself thought he's eccentric. Have you seen that home?
Yes. I visited that. It's a very good idea.
Father Prior did it with the help of the people, and he entrusted the whole thing to be done by the organization of the lay people. For the first time in our country, such an organization has come up.
The two we agree, but press?
Father Prior knows the need of a press. He says, if we do good works with good intentions and take effort for it, God will do the rest. So I'm sure his dream of the press will be successful. Have you heard about his dream of a convent?
Another madness. I was just about to tell you that. Who will send their girls to the convents?
If it's God's will, he knows it'll succeed.
Father Thopil, this is the land I spoke about for the convent. This is the family property of Elisha and her daughter Anna. Her uncle has consented to give this property to them. He has some loans on the land, and I have agreed to repay the loans.
But Father Prior, at present we don't have money for these and for convent construction.
I've received 18 rupees as donation from two persons. With people's contribution, we will complete the construction. For the beginning, we will make a temporary convent.
Walk fast. Father Prayer is coming to preach. Walk fast.
Walk fast, otherwise we will not get place.
Dear brethren in our Lord Jesus Christ, let love be the law of your life. Let that love compel you to forgive each other. Let the love in your heart overflow to everyone. There is no man who never mistakes, and there is no mistake that God does not forgive. When you serve the poor and the needy, and when you clean the wounds of the sick, remember that the Lord Jesus Himself is present in front of you. The day in which you did not do any good to others will not be counted in your life.
Your glory and splendor, O Son of God, I long to see. Splendor, O Son of God, I long to see. Your glory and splendor, O Son of God, I long to see. Your glory and splendor, O Son of God, I long to see. I long to see.